Hello, this presentation is about the benefits that you can get out of enterprise architecture reporting. My name is Helmut and I would like to guide you through this presentation. First we cover the BI and the reporting term. I will then create the use case scenario with a typical enterprise architecture model. What kind of reports maybe do we want? And I will also run an impact analysis report at the end of this use case scenario. I will then cover other questions that might be applicable for your enterprise architecture project, and at the end we go through the benefits for enterprise architecture reporting. So let's start. What is BI and what is reporting? Business intelligence refers to skills, technologies, applications and practices used to help a business acquire a better understanding of its commercial, competitive, operational context. Business intelligence also refers to the collected information itself. That's why we speak normally about reporting. Business intelligence refers to the use of a company data to facilitate decision making by decision makers, which means understanding current functioning and anticipating actions for well-informed steering of the enterprise. That's very important that you have an enterprise architecture model as a knowledge base, as a central repository in place. The Gartner quote here mentioned that through 2012, more than 35% of the top 5,000 global companies will regularly fail to make insightful decisions about significant changes in their business and markets. So what does a typical EA model now contain? First of all, we have in the center our organization units, in my case an example here, finance. This organization unit is based, located on a location, for example, New York. Organization units are normally performing processes like check credit. Processes are supported by applications, in my case, for SAP FI. Applications are also using data like customer name, but also the processes using data. Applications are normally running on technologies. In my case is a server XYZ, and the server of course is also on a location based, in my case it's Vienna, nice place in Austria. So these are normally this kind of objects that are important for an enterprise architecture model. That not all the objects, there could be much more, like business goals, KPIs, critical success factors. So you can add whatever you like, whatever your requirements are. Important in the background that you have a repository that allows you to extend your metadata for your enterprise architecture model. Another example here, for the compliance requirements, for example SOX, they have the requirements for organization unit, for processes, application, and of course for data as well. Just think about the SOX requirement for segregation of duties, so it's applicable to all types of information objects here. So these are some kind of logical model for this EA. Then we have different user groups, different stakeholders like the business analyst, they're dealing with organization unit, processes, location, maybe they're also adding application to the processes. The other stakeholders could be the enterprise architects. They are responsible for maintaining the application, technology, location, data, interfaces, software components and much more. And finally, we look to our compliance teams. In our case, SOX team, their requirements feed into a lot of different information objects. That means it's important that all the different people are working in the central repository, so that gets most out of it afterwards for the reporting. If they would use Excel, Visio, Word, it would be all lost and no reusable data can be benefit. So, what kind of reports do I want? First of all, you have all the different information artifacts that you can report on. And normally it's quite straightforward to report on which organization unit is performing which process, or which process is using which application, and so on. So this is a very straightforward line. All the different tool vendors should support this kind of basic reporting. What I would like to focus here is on an indirect reporting. So for example, I'm interested in the location in Vienna, and I would like to get a report on all the affected organization units. So for example, which organization unit is affected if our IT center in Vienna is flooded? So this is important for business continuity. This could be important for any kind of change request if I have some kind of service outage. So that's one question that I would like to focus on. We can do this by following the chain of associations from location to technology, technology to application, application to process, and process finally to organization unit. So there's no direct relationship between the location Vienna and the organization unit in finance, but we can go through this chain of association. This is what I call indirect association report. So the impact analysis report that we can see here, on the left right hand side you can see my SQL reporting server where I select my model. On the left hand side you can see our chain of association that we follow for location, technology, application, process, organization. Let's start by selecting the source object, the location. The second step is then our target object, where I select my organization unit. As you can see, this report is flexible and you can report any kind of other scenarios as well. The source object that I select here is my Vienna IT center, but again here you can select all the different locations that you might have in your repository. And now it's important that we exclude objects. We don't want to report on everything, we just focus on the application itself. Scroll down a bit, then we can also deselect the process, and we also deselect the technology, as we just focus on location, technology, application, process, and organization unit. And this is very important that I've just focused on those objects, because if you think back, we could have compliance objects, KPI, critical success factors. I don't want to focus on them in this report. Again, just focus, narrow it down as much as I can to get a very precise and clear report. So, just minimizing the windows here to get a bigger screen. And now what we can see a standard report with header and the content. We can see the source object name, our Vienna IT center, and I can see two different organization units. The finance, I can see my technology, the server, the application, the process, actually two processes. And I can also see actually a second organization unit, the warehouse, which I'm quite surprised here. But again, this is the impact analysis. I can see that there's also a process called check order complete, which is also feeds together into this chain of indirect associations. So what other questions can we answer with this type of reporting? So for generic modeling questions, for example, all the change histories. What objects are changed? I can see the old, the new value. I can compare them. For business process analysis, I can compare multiple diagrams, multiple scenarios, as is, to be. I can compare their associations. For enterprise architecture, we have just seen this impact analysis for your enterprise artifacts, can be used for business continuity, for get an understanding of impact analysis in generic terms. Governance, risk and compliance, you can report on your current compliance status of your multiple compliance regimes and identify weak spots. You can perform risk assessments. So there's a wide variety of usage for this type of report. The reporting benefits for EA are quite clear, so it's a flexible, scalable reporting solution. It's easy to customize and accessible for everyone, so every stakeholder should have access answering their specific questions. You can save time and costs by using this indirect relationship reporting instead of maintaining multiple inconsistent relationships in your model. You understand the relationships between the not direct associated objects. This will help you to build impact analysis business continuity reports. Another benefit is you build reports for different stakeholders. This will strengthen your communication skills and reduce the resistance to change of your projects. So it's now time for a break. Thanks for your attention, and any feedback is more than welcome.